Herming Ching built a little hospital there in 1935. She traveled to every home where there was anybody sick, in the mountains and in your village. She went through the Japanese lines to Beijing and brought back supplies for the Balujun.
I quite like Tom Noonan's comment. Kathleen Hall was a truly great New Zealander. Great because of her capacity to give of herself sacrificially. Great because of the love and the warmth with which she worked with ordinary Chinese people at a time of chaos and bitterness.
I remember her as a diminutive woman, full of energy and purpose, but also showing great kindness to people.
A woman of faith, a woman of great personal Christian commitment. She was a compassionate nurse, deeply cared about the people she came across and was asked to serve amongst. She was passionately concerned about reconciliation, working as between and across cultures to enable understanding and trust that develops from understanding of a different culture and different peoples.
She was a nurse, and she went to the poorer parts of China because she wanted to improve the health and well-being of the peasants. And she lived in the northern provinces, which were the poorest part of China. And the Chinese called her Her Ming Ching, which means clear, bright, and earnest.
Kathleen Hall was born in Napier on 4th of October, 1896, the fifth child in a family of seven. She attended a private primary school in Napier until 1909. The Hall family then relocated to Auckland for Kathleen's father's work, where Kathleen attended the Ladies' College in Remuera. On leaving school, Kathleen was supposed to stay home and help her mother. However, after her elder sister returned home, she took the opportunity to train as a nurse at Auckland Hospital. She was registered in 1921 and was soon promoted to become a nursing sister. While working at Auckland Hospital, she met Crichton McDowell, an Anglican priest and missionary who was on furlough in New Zealand from his work in the north of China with the Society for the Propagation of the Gospel. Kathleen had been involved in church and Bible class activities for some time, and wanting to serve God, she volunteered for work in the missionary field. In 1922, she was accepted by the Society for Missionary Work in China. Before leaving, she trained in midwifery at St. Helens Hospital, Christchurch. In 1923, filled with a fascination for the mysterious Orient, Kathleen traveled to China. Her loved ones never expected that her heart would be left forever in that strange land. Kathleen spent 2 years studying Chinese language, history, and culture in Peking. At that time, there was one outstanding hospital established in 1906 where Western medicine was practiced, the Peking Union Medical College. Kathleen Hall was given a teaching position, and during this time, she built up her teaching role to two classes, each with 30 students. In China at that time, warlordism was rife. Hunger, poverty, and calamity were everywhere. Warm-hearted Kathleen moved to sympathy, nursed in Peking and Datong, and in 1927, her Anglican church set up St. Barnabas Hospital in Anguo County, Hebei Province. That was the first Western hospital in the northern China countryside. And Kathleen was matron in charge of administration. Kathleen trained about 60 nurses. Some became her assistant, while others went to more remote villages where medical care was even less available. Kathleen was appointed sister in charge of a provincial hospital at Datong, later being transferred to the same position at Hejian and Anguo in Hebei province. In 1935, she overcame great difficulties to set up a church and a clinic in Niuyangou village, Tangxian, deep in the Taihan Mountains. And later, her main clinic, many kilometers away at Songjiazhuang in Qiyang County. In 5 months, she made 400 visits to homes, tended to 3,000 patients, and set up clinics and afternoon classes for girls and night classes for men and boys. In 1937, she had to return temporarily to take charge of the hospital at Anguo on the plains, and she was in charge there when the Japanese invaded. This was the country Kathleen had to cover on her rounds, sometimes 5 or 6 times a day. She came to know the hardship faced by the farmers and respected their simple values. Her Chinese became even more fluent, and she completely submerged herself in the vast pulse of China. In letters to her mother, she wrote, "Working in the Taihan, I feel the poverty and backwardness of the people, but I have great love for them."
这个孙子拿过，孙子拿过以后就是到拿过上治疗，治疗了以后治疗好了，何先生跟我岳母一块儿又跟着回来，跟着回来以后岳母好了，一直到现在还活着呢。
现在多大岁数了？
现在是84。这从这个时候，我岳母都知道，感动的一说就想着哭。
我自己啊，也叫何先生看过病，因为当时我好鼻子流血，不知为什么鼻子好鼻出血，我们叫鼻扭啊，这一个鼻子旁那边一个抽子啊，咱们大夫们叫鼻扭，当时有这个病，何先生给我亲自看过。何先生的时候吧，这个出诊很多，有些老乡开始不知道他常住，后来就知道了，说宋院长有一个外国女大夫叫何先生，大家都让开了，说以后3里5里乡这个都来找他。何先生啊，这个人他都不怕脏臭啊，怎么脏怎么臭他都不怕。我们那个地方相当的脏了，老乡啊，所以说啊，这个作为一个说实在的高阶子高薪层高薪阶层的这么一个人，这么一个外国妇女啊，能够在我们那地方住下来，能让人家落后，这是非常的不简单。
Norman Bethune was a Canadian surgeon, early advocate of socialized medicine, and a member of the Communist Party of Canada, who was sent to support the Communist Party of China's 8th Route Army during the Chinese War against the Japanese invasion. Bethune helped bring modern medicine to rural China and often treated sick villagers as much as wounded soldiers. When Bethune was visiting Nguyen Go Hospital in the end of 1938, he was told that a Kiwi missionary nurse named He Mingqing had a clinic in Songjiazhuang and had been helping the local people unselfishly. Bethune was so pleased to hear that, as he had not seen anyone from English-speaking countries for quite a long time. In Bethune's diary, he wrote, "I met an angel." Bethune decided to approach Catherine to do something for the 8th Route Army. But before he put forward his request, he invited Kathleen to visit the hospital he was working in. Kathleen saw the hospital was really lacking medical supplies and medications. A couple of days later, Kathleen invited Bethune to do an operation in Anguo Hospital and was impressed by Bethune's skill. And then Bethune asked if Kathleen would also bring back medical supplies for the army. Although she was opposed to war, Kathleen decided that the saving of lives was God's will. The following morning, she went to Bethune and told him she had decided to help. Kathleen not only organized mule trains of medical supplies and saw them through Japanese checkpoints, but also attended to wounded soldiers and partisans and recruited nurses for the army, bringing them through the rough terrain and mountains.
明清就来到西河医院来见我，而且告诉我在解放区的很多很多故事。他说抗日军呢都是非常有礼貌，非常守纪律在我们的解放区做了很多工作，对老百姓也是非常要好。我也希望像你们受过教育、受过正规的医学教育的人都能上农村去为人民服务，为部队服务，为村子里面的贫苦农民服务。所以从那个以后我就想我应当去。所以他3月份他来到北平5月份我就离开了西河医院，他就给我从北平买了一个二等票火车票。在那个时候二等火车票 都是日本人掌握了，别人不能坐。一个就是平民百姓不能上二等车，我跟他坐了二等车，在车上都是日本的比较高级军官，他们都是带着刺刀带着枪跟我们坐在一个车厢。我那时候也有点害怕，但是有贺民情我就不害怕。在宋家庄，哎呀，小子，好多小孩子，何先生你回来了，特别高兴。他们那么多小孩子都啊，但是我就看见八路军了。以后他就请他们一个姓康的一个康先生，他就给我背了一条毛驴，也是我把我的行李都拿着，我就算参军了。我就到了三峰区，那个时候三峰区是军城北关，是要这些商品要送到解放区，也有好多人都牺牲了，因为日本人发现哈，你是把敌占区的东西都送给他，所以很危险啊。我们还后边带着四辆大车，都是药品器材。我们走到丁县的一个地方，我们都看见日本人带着很多民工在修路。在这个时候日本人就过来了，他看因为我们是过路的，要问我们你们上哪儿去。贺民勤就过来了，过来就把他的护照拿出来，他是英国人的护照，他说我是英国人，我在安国有一个医院，我要把这些药品送到安国去。我们带的那些东西啊，日本人要一个一个检查，检查他就在上边放一层饼干，吃的饼干啊。日本人说了，外国人爱吃饼干，过去吧。
其实下面是什么呢？
其实下边是医疗器械，还有电池，军用的电池。他带了好多好多最秘密的东西，他都放在最下边。他非常聪明，也非常精致，也非常勇敢。我们的女人这样子的人很少。哎呀，为中国人民牺牲这么多，真是很少。所以我非常感人，我这一辈子我都忘不了他。
I have this enduring memory of Auntie Kate striding up our driveway, dressed in her very worn grey overcoat with a black beret and her coattails just flying out behind her. And that's something I just remember distinctly. And I think that that's an image of how she would have been in China, striding along the pathways, mountain pathways, to her villages.
She came back to New Zealand to look after her mother. They came back to Hamilton because her sister had married a farmer out at Raglan. And the two of them decided, well, why not look after the mother and Kathleen? So they built a little house overlooking Raglan Harbour. And they lived there until the mother died in 1948. Kathleen went to Hong Kong and she worked in a leprosarium for a couple of years, came back. She decided that she should really be with her family back in the Waikato, and she came to Hamilton. And there she met up with Bishop Holland. He was looking for a European missionary to work with a Maori missionary called Kanunui Huata. And then Kanunui Huata took her down to Waitara. And there she walked, just visiting families. And she always had a medical bag with her, just in case someone needed some medical treatment. She was called back to Tikawiti, and she stayed in Tikawiti for about 4 years, doing her missionary work. She was then 60, and she went up to Auckland, and she lived in Weymouth, which is South Auckland. There was a group of people that had formed the China Friendship Society, and within no time she was on the committee, and she went down to Wellington as a delegate. The idea of the conference was to join all the friendship societies together to make the New Zealand-China Friendship Society. Her service, a celebration of her life, was held at the St. Peter's Cathedral, and Canon Wee Hu Ata took the service, and a lot of Maori women that she had known in Waitara, Rotorua, Tikawiti came up and sang at her service.
In 1996, I was a fairly new Bishop of Auckland, and the New Zealand-China Friendship Society asked the Anglican Church, through the then Archbishop, whether the Anglican Church wished to be associated with a tour group going to China to mark the centenary of Kathleen Hall's birth. The Archbishop of the time asked me, as the Bishop of the diocese from which Kathleen had been sent, to go, and my wife accompanied me, and we went off and met up with the tour party in Beijing, and we travelled to a number of different sites, and then made our way to Songjiazhuang, which was the village where Kathleen Hall had spent a good deal of her time as a nurse. The Chinese authorities in the Hebei province had commissioned a very large statue of Kathleen and placed it in the grounds of the school where Kathleen had actually had her mission station. I think Kathleen Hall should be remembered as a woman of faith, as a nurse with a compassionate heart, as a person passionately concerned about peace, as one who was very concerned working across cultures with reconciliation between peoples, providing understanding as a basis from which trust can develop.
In 2006, the He Mingqing Memorial Scholarship was established by the Society to replace the Kathleen Hall Centennial Memorial Scholarship. The scholarship covers books, board, travel, and the full fees for a female student from a poor area in China to complete their degree at a local medical college or university. So far, we have 8 scholars, and 2 of those are currently students at a medical college.
It's sort of only in more recent years that I've come to fully understand her life. But I have her books, and I have her memories, and I have her photos, and I want my children to understand. I bought them copies of the books, and I think it's just a life that we can all look to for significance and, yeah, of a way to live our lives. She makes me immensely proud to be part of her family.